بسم الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وأزال عنا الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. ثم أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما.
I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his last and final messenger. Your brother and sister in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us, given us countless blessings. And one of the blessings that today, inshallah, we're going to stop by is the greatest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his rewards to us. The blessing that most of us overlook. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran al-Kareem, in Surah Al-An'am,
مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ عَشْرُ أَمْثَالِهَا.
Whoever comes with one good deed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply it by 10. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't stop his blessings here. He continued the ayah with,
مَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا مِثْلَهَا.
And whoever comes with one evil deed will be replied only with one with its equivalent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah shows us the greatness, the mercy, the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brother and sister in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't stop his generosity in this ayah. He continued his generosity in another ayah. Listen to this beautiful ayah in Surah Al-Furqan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما.
الله سبحانه وتعالى in this ayah says, if you repent, if you believe, if you ever come back, if you ever come back to us, He will not only forgive you this sin, He will not only forgive us this sin, but He will replace our sins with good deeds, with hasanat. It was narrated by Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, hadith on Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever comes with one good deed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply it by 10. And not even that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continued here, it will be multiplied by 10 or even more. Rawahu Muslim. That's why, dear brother, we should love him. He is azim. We should obey him. He's the greatest. We should rely on him. He's the most merciful and he's the most generous. And always remember that we're leaving this dunya, that we're leaving everything behind us and only taking our good deeds to the hereafter. So while we can in this dunya, we should take that advantage of this blessing of multiplying our hasanat by 10. To Allah we belong and to Him we will return. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. In the first khutbah we mentioned that we should take advantage of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessings of multiplying our deeds by 10 or more. That doesn't mean that we should pray all night without sleeping. That doesn't mean we should read Quran or read the Holy Quran every single day. See how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam simplified for us in this hadith. An Aisha radiyallahu anha anna Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam qal, "Saddidu wa qaribu wa'lamu an la yudkhila ahadukum 'amalahu al-jannah wa anna ahabba al-a'mali ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala adwamuha in qallat wa in qallat." The most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's those consistently, even if they are few. What we can learn from these ayahs and from the hadith that we just heard, that we should perform daily good deeds, even if they are small, even if they are few. But they should be consistent. For example, reading one page of Quran a day, pray sunnah before and after salah, making a small sadaqah daily to your masjid, to their nearest masjid, reciting adhkar after each salah, spending time with your family, spending time with your kids, teaching them about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or maybe reading one ayah a day with them. The time is not enough to mention all the good deeds that we can do consistently. But at least think about one good deed that you can start doing it today. Start from today. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from His righteous people. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us our sins. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to replace our sins with the good deeds and to be amongst those who multiply by 10. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to multiply by 10 or even more. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم ولذكر الله أكبر اذكروا الله يذكركم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين وأقيم الصلاة.